out there looking, when all of a sudden I find myself smack dab in the middle of this explosion, this burning, blinding, scorching explosion. Must have been a boom shot or something, because all around you were fire. Hell, I'm on fire. Like a piece of chicken dropped in the skin of the crackling grease. Why, the flesh was just peeling off my bone. But then I said to myself, Judy, if your flesh is on fire, how come you don't feel no pain? And I did. I swear, as I'm standing here, I felt nothing. And that's when I started putting two and two together and realized the reason I feel a whole lot of hurt is because I don't die. Well, I just picked myself up. I won't smile out of that explosion. Hell, once you know you're dead, why keep on dying? So like I said, I won't smile out of that explosion, fully expecting to see white clouds, Jesus, and my mom. Only what I saw was more war. Shooting going on in this direction and that direction. And then standing all around with a guy. Yeah, Cupid, the captain. I guess the sound of the explosion must have attracted them. Because they all staring at me like I'm some sort of ghost. So I yell to them. Hey, captain. Hey, hey, Cupid. But they just stared. So I tell them how I died. I guess not been my time, because here I is, fully in the flesh, and not a scratch to my bones. But he's still just staring. So I took to staring back. Only what I saw. But I can't exactly to this day describe it. But I swear, as sure as they were really blue and holding color, they each had a piece of the future on their faces. If all the hurt that was going to be done to them and that they were going to do before was right there. Yes, dude. I saw how Jada, once she got back to Chicago, was going to get shot dead by this police. And how Cupid was going to start beating up on her double A, which I couldn't understand, because all he could do was talk on and on about how much he loved her. Each and every one of them have pain in his future and blood on his path. And God, or the devil, once spoke to me and said, Junie, these colored boys ain't going to be the same after this war. They ain't going to find no kind of happiness. It came to me. The secret you left painted. Late that night, after the medics had checked me over and found me fit for fighting, after everybody had settled down for the evening, I snuck over to where the human was sleeping, and with a needle I stole from the medics. I shot a little gear in his veins. Second he died, all the hurt to come just left his veins. 2 weeks later, I got J.A. And after that, Woodrow, Jimmy Joe. I even stayed up late one night by the tree.
Because I knew the captain always made a late time visit.